Iraqi forces say they are making gains in Mosul. They've taken four districts east of the city after fierce fighting. Villages to the south and the east have also been liberated. But there are still big challenges, like disarming mines left by the retreating militants. CCTV's Jack Barton has more from nearby Erbil.
Well, the official word from the general in charge of the Mosul offensive today is that the operation has slowed because of the high number of people still trapped inside the city by ISIL, and the fact that ISIL is using them as a human shield is proving to be effective, if not terrifying, for the local population. Because of this, there is an expectation now that the Kurdish Peshmerga will probably open up a northern front, but it is very slow going. What they are trying to do in the meantime is consolidate those suburbs that are already in the hands of the Iraqi security forces. But also allegations out today that the Iraqi Federal Police may have been involved in human rights abuses. The federal police are involved in the battle for Mosul. They do have a military role here in Iraq, and they are used extensively in the villages around the city. And what Amnesty International is saying is that 10 males, one of them 16-year-old, who tried to get away from ISIL when they were bringing people back into Mosul to act as human shields, approached the police, who then tortured them and murdered most of them. It's not the first time in Iraq that the Iraqi Federal Police have been accused of human rights abuses. The chief of the Federal Police is denying the allegations, though, and he's saying that his men are acting in line with the directive of the Prime Minister, Haider al-Abadi, that sectarian politics should not become a part of this offensive to capture ISIL's last stronghold in the country. Jack Barton, CCTV, Erbil.